Hey, Lisa Kay here, and we are going to the tour. You can see the sign behind me. Let's see if I can get it for you. And it's about 10:30, 11 o'clock in the morning, and it's a beautiful morning. We just had some incredible storm yesterday, and Storm Angus, and it's created a lot of mess on this ground. But we couldn't come yesterday, but today, I think we're gonna have beautiful weather. Look at the sun. All right, we're gonna walk up. We'll see you up there. Now, the Tor, like Glastonbury itself, is linked to the legends of King Arthur and Celtic myths. And it is said that the king of the fairies, Gwyn Ap Nudd, lives in a crystal castle with the fairies deep inside the hill. And maybe that's why we saw so many happy dogs running around on the way up the hill. I think she's calling her dog. But he doesn't want to go. He could bring a stick. Good dog. The Glastonbury Tor is a hill near the town of Glastonbury, that is in the English county of Somerset. And at the top of the hill is St. Michael's Tower. And the tower is all that remains of the stone church of St. Michael that was built on the site in the 14th century. The Tor seems to have been known by the Britons as the Isle of Avalon, and it's believed by some people to be the Avalon of the Arthurian legend of King Arthur. Now, the Tor is thought to represent an entrance or a gateway to Anwen or Avalon, and which is the land of the fairies. People have inhabited the hill where the Tor sits since prehistoric times. And in early medieval times, there was a monk's retreat on top of the Tor, which probably was founded around the mid-400s. The Glastonbury Tor Hill is 518 feet in elevation. The sides of the Tor have seven deep, roughly symmetrical terraces. Now, the formation of these terraces is a mystery, though lots of explanations have been dreamed up for them, ranging from them being a labyrinth to being part of a defensive fort. The Glastonbury Tor is also thought to be a centerpiece where there are the crossing of the ley lines, which are these magnetic lines that go through the earth, and where they meet or where they cross over is normally thought to be a very special place.